You know, Mickey Mouse boy, top of it. You know what I mean? We have a great topic tonight, a great topic. Let's get more people in the live. We have an amazing topic tonight. Bands the Gent, 365, top of it. Did you choose with your or your mind? You know what I'm saying? We're going to put the title. You know what I mean? Did you choose with your pussy or your mind? And then why many don't believe they could be rich with black women? You know what I mean? We're going to talk about it tonight. Let's add people to the live. Did you choose with your pussy or your mind? While many don't believe they can be rich with black women within the lifestyle or outside of the lifestyle. You know what I'm saying? We're going to talk about it tonight, though, man. You know what I'm saying? A great topic tonight. Blessing to everybody that's in the live. Let's get the ladies in the live. Let's get everybody in the live. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? Peace and blessings to everybody. You know? Let's get more people in the live. I hope everybody had a prosperous day. And this, you know, this topic, a lot of people might disagree with some of the things that I have to say. You know what I mean? But tonight, you know, I'm giving nothing but the truth. I can't beat around a bush. I gotta call it the way I see it. You know? Top of it. You know what I mean? That music in the background, man, that's the stylistics. That hurry up this way again, man. There's even a message within the song. Hurry up this way again. You know what I'm saying? Top of it. Off top, man. Appreciate it. We're gonna dive right in. Did you choose with your pussy or your mind? You know what I mean? This topic, man, is very, very, very essential, man, because a lot of people, man, they not choosing with the right things. They choosing based off of what they pussy feel, based off of what they thought, or based off of what they know. You know what I mean? Thinking becomes an afterthought. That's all I always ask the question. If you met the man in which, you know, your ideal man, you know, in regards to looks, if he looked like what you would physically want, you know what I mean? He's handsome, he's cute. You know what I mean? And he had a big old dick. You know what I'm saying? At the end of the day, would that be enough? Do you think that the end result would still be success? You know what I mean? Would that still equal success if you had the ideal male that you wanted? You know what I mean? Because that's a real question. Would it still amount to success? Or a success of afterthought. That's why I always post that on my Instagram. Ambassador Ron posts that a lot. Cynic, top of it. You know what I mean? But without further ado, let me get right into the topic. Hey, Bands, I want to add you in the topic once we get more people in here, man. But I want to start with the topic and get it flowing. And I definitely, we need the ladies in this live, man. There's no reason why we don't have a certain amount of women in this live. You know what I'm saying? But my question, man, you know, I have to ask this question to a lot of the ladies, man. You know, Bill, top of it. Blessings to Bill. This is a very important topic. And let me say this too. Punchy, top of it. Let me say this too. This topic, it's so important. It goes deeper than just the lifestyle. Man, the topic goes way deeper than just the lifestyle, man. We about to really drop some real jewels in his live tonight. You know what I mean? And I want to have Bill and Bands join the live. But before we do that, I still want to get deeper into the message and really talk about it. You know what I mean? Man, the question I got, you know what I'm saying? And a lot of young ladies, you know, they may listen to this live a little bit later, and a lot of the fellas might listen to this live later. But the question I have is, you know, if sex is so important, you know, in a relationship, why be in a serious relationship? You know what I mean? Why endeavor to even be in this lifestyle if fucking is, you know what I mean, that important to you? You know what I mean? Just have fuck buddies for the rest of your life. You know what I mean? Arthur, top of it. Let's add more people to the live. You know what I mean? Just have fuck buddies for the rest of your life. You know what I mean? There's no purpose in, you know what I mean, even having anything serious. You shouldn't trip off of what woman he, you know, talks to, because at the end of the day, it's just about dick for you. You know what I'm saying? If it's all about, you know what I mean, your sexual desires, why do children even matter? Why even have children? If sex is the highest priority, you know what I mean? Because we got to talk about this in a lifestyle and even outside of the lifestyle, because it's too many people, you know, in all reality, they're choosing just off of that. Believe it or not, there's a number of individuals that are only in this lifestyle, some of the fellas that are only in this lifestyle because they want some pussy. You know what I mean? If we're going to keep it real, they're not in this lifestyle to get no generational wealth or nothing like that. They only in the lifestyle because they want some goddamn pussy. And this is a slick way for them to get some pussy. If we're going to keep it real, you know what I'm saying? So, I'm not a fan of just doing things just to do it. You know what I mean? I believe in, you know, if I'm a fuck, we're going to fuck with a purpose. You know what I mean? I'm not into just doing things just to do it, because that would make you a trick. If you're just doing things just because, you know, just to do it, what separates you from a trick? You know what I mean? So, you got to ask yourself that. And another thing is this. Black females prioritize sex more than any other race of women. You know, I had to make that statement, man. A lot of people might not agree. They'd be like, oh, Ron, you, come on, man, Ron. Come on, Ron. You know what I mean? Every bitch likes fucking. That's not what I said, though. That's not what I said. Black females prioritize sex more than any other race of women or any other race of females. You know what I mean? They prioritize the wrong things. I'm just going to keep it real. Now, I'm not speaking for one person in particular. I'm speaking as a mass. You know, I can back up everything that I'm saying. You know what I mean? Majority of impoverished households are held by single black women with children. And if you don't believe me, I want you to look it up. Go to blackstatistics.com and go to households, black households, and scroll all the way down, and exactly what I'm saying will show. Okay? So I just gave a little bit of homework for y'all. So, you know what I mean? Because if it was all about a man's character, there wouldn't be single black women, you know what I'm saying, with children in poverty. You have more black women in Section 8 than ever before. You know what I mean? In public housing, in ghettos. But hey, you know, I got my own spot. You know what I mean? I got my own spot. You know what I mean? I don't need a nigga. I got my own spot. Fuck these niggas. You know what I mean? Pussy pig booty hole brown. You know what I mean? That's their mentality. You know what I'm saying? So, you don't see any other race of bras doing this. You don't see Arab, anti, top of it. You don't see Arabian women prioritizing sex. You don't see them running around here talking about pussy pink booty hole brown. Take me to pound town. I'm thugging with my rounds. You don't see Arabian women doing that. You don't see Asian women doing that. You don't see Filipino women doing that. You don't see Caucasians doing that. You know what I'm saying? Beautiful Marv, how you doing? Blessings. But you don't see Arab and Asian and Filipino and Caucasian women prioritizing sex over success. And I just have to tell the truth. Now, I'm not speaking about anybody, you know, as an individual. I'm talking about the masses. You know what I mean? I'm speaking about the masses. And the reality is, their views of success are surrounded by sexual sensations. Their views of success are surrounded by sexual sensations. Let's add more people to the live. We have to add more women to the live. And see, a lot of people are not going to say what I'm saying because they're scared to hold themselves and that bitch accountable. I'm just going to call it the way I see it. They're scared to do that. They're scared to hold her accountable. They're scared to hold themselves accountable. That's why I say, you know, at the end of the day, two people should write down their top five highest needs. You know, rather you in a square relationship, Mac Maroy, top of it. Two people should write down. Two people should write down, you know what I'm saying, their highest needs in a relationship and see where sex ranks. And this is real because there's no way you're going to be successful if they prioritize your sexual desires over success. I am yo, top of it. And I'm just keeping it real. Black females prioritize sex more than any other race. $2 Steve, top of it. That's why you see a lot of brothers saying they want white bitches. And I'm just going to keep it real. You know what I mean? That's why you see a number of black brothers saying, I'd rather have me a white bitch, because at the end of the day, you know what I'm saying? If you sit up there and you have a black female, she's going to prioritize sex more than any other race. You know what I mean? The Arab, the Asian, the Filipino, the Caucasian, all the other races. You know what I mean? All the other races, they don't prioritize sex over success. The topic is pinned at the bottom, beautiful. But you know what I mean? It's about, what did you choose? Did you choose with your mind or your pussy? Did you choose the man based off of his physical appearance? You know what I mean? I do it for the bag, top of it. Did you choose the man based off of his physical appearance, or did you choose the man based off of his mindset? Because there's too many people that are looking for the ideal man, but not the man with the right ideas. You know what I mean? I'm going to say it again. It's a lot of them looking for the ideal man, but not the man with the right ideas. Upscale game, top of it. And that is the call. That is one of the causes of the broken family today. There are many other causes, but that's one of them. You know what I'm saying? So what I suggest is two people come together, write down their five highest needs. And if sex ranks higher on her list than it does in yours, you know what I mean? Then that should let you know that you guys might not be compatible. Do you want to come or come up? Facts. You know what I mean? Do you want to come or come up? Because my thing is this, and I want every man to take heed to what I'm saying right now, because this is the truth. Many just want dick all the time to stroke their ego. It's not because she love you or because she think your dick is huge and you got a fucking 20-inch dick, you know. If you think that a bitch loves you just because of your dick, you're gladly mistaken. You're sadly mistaken, excuse me. You sadly mistaken. If a bitch could push out a baby, you know, Savage Don Dada, top of it. If a bitch could push out a baby, what make you think that your dick is so great to where she'll never want anybody else's dick, you know what I mean, in her life? You know what I mean? Because a lot of these bitches ain't coming nor coming up. They know the more dick they get, the more likely it is that you're going to get them a baby. That you're going to give her a baby. Let's just be real. I'm just going to tell the truth. It's not that you're so great. I know, you know, have you ever met a man that say, you know what, I suck when it come to fucking bitches? No. No. You had to, no. You know what I'm saying? Savage, top of it. You haven't, there is not a man out there that sat up there and said, you know what, I'm going to be real. You know what I mean? I suck in bed. You know, I suck when it come to fucking bitches. You know what I'm saying? You know, no. You know what I'm saying? They know the more dick that you give them, the more likely it is that you're going to give them a baby. And they, and their way of having any type of power over you is to control your dick. Control you with sexual sensations. You know what I mean? They want power. That's why they leave the man, you know what I mean, that can control his sexual desires. They get the fuck on from him because they say, you know what? He not going to give me what the fuck I want. And then what a bitch will do is hit you with insult. You probably got a little dick. You probably don't know how to fuck. You probably gay. And that's another way of saying all I have to offer is my pussy. You know what I mean? That's the only thing I got to offer is my vagina. And I can't control you with my pussy. And since I can't control you with my pussy, I'm going to insult you. I'm going to try to poke at your ego. You know what I mean? It's either I'm going to stroke your ego. You know what I mean? It's either I'm going to stroke that motherfucker by telling you that you beat my shit up and you the best thing I ever had. And, you know, come on, man. Look, these bitches ain't had all type of individuals. KB. KB the Don, top of it. She's either going to stroke your ego and tell you, ooh, daddy, you wore me out. Whew. You know what I'm saying? You was beating my shit up. Like, daddy do it better. Like, you know what I'm saying? Ain't nobody ever did it like you. You know what I'm saying? It's either she going to stroke your ego or she going to poke at your ego. You know what I mean? You, are you gay? Do you got a little dick? You know what I mean? It's one of the two. But regardless, her goal is to get power. Because a lot of bitches leave when they can't get power leverage over you. Because you might think, damn, you know what I mean? The bitch left out of nowhere. I didn't even do nothing wrong. Then you find yourself saying, maybe I mispimped. You know what I mean? Maybe I mispimped. Maybe I said something wrong. Maybe I did something wrong. You know what I mean? You know, things was cool. It wasn't that. It wasn't that you mispimped or you did something wrong. What it was is she identified that she's not going to have leverage over you. She couldn't control you with her pussy. She didn't want no goddamn pimp. And a lot of people need to understand that these bitches, majority of them, don't want a pimp. You can talk like one. You can dress like one. But behind closed doors, no, don't put your foot down. You know what I mean? Chief Checkaho, top of it. Let's add more people to the live. Behind closed doors, no, the bitch does not want you to be an actual pimp. You know what I mean? Behind closed doors, she wants you to eat ass, apologize, give her all the dick that she can handle. And you know what I mean? And she wants you to stroke her ego. Because the more dick you give a bitch that's used to it, that's all you're doing is stroking her ego. And then when you stroke her ego too much, there's no balance. A lot of bitches leave because they say, you know what? I'm used to the situation. I got bored. They selling their balls in order to ball. A lot of bitches get bored of a situation because what tends to happen is, you know, a lot of niggas, they dick theyself out of a, I'm not going to say they dick theyself out of a bitch, but what tends to happen is they fuck the bitch so much, they get bored of the bitch. You know what I mean? And another bitch comes that's more marketable. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, he's more in tune and sexually aroused by her than he is the bitch he been fucking on. You know what I'm saying? So he tired of this bitch. He really tired of this bitch. You know what I mean? Like, man, I'm tired of this bitch. But she was able to control you. Because she was able to manipulate you by thinking that if you give me more dick, I'm going to be in pocket. If you give me more dick, I believe that we have a genuine connection. She don't give a fuck about your dick. You know what I mean? She only wants to control you. That's why a lot of bitches want to fuck all the time and suck all the time. A lot of these bitches is not coming. They don't experience orgasm. Bitches don't even know the difference between arousal fluid versus discharge. Bitch don't even know about her body. Draco 3X22. You know what I mean? It's not that you didn't did something miraculous. You know what I mean? I wore the bitch back out. Man, look. You know what I mean? Only if you knew. A lot of bitches, if her power is only in her, if she believes her power is only in her pussy and not within your game, you'll never be wealthy with that bitch. Because she's always going to pick a sensation over success. She's always going to pick her sexual desires over your game. You'll never be rich with them ghetto ass bitches. You'll never be wealthy with them bitches that, you know what I mean, sat up there and came from a situation in which all he was doing was fucking on a bitch. And I always tell him, and not only is it power thing in regards to them wanting to give the dude the pussy, you know what I mean, so much to where he makes him weak. A lot of bitches have the I'm not even say the thought processing, because it's not even thinking in that. A lot of them really believe that if I give him enough pussy, he's going to fall in love and become the trick that I always wanted him to become. A lot of bitches say, you know what, I see him being a good husband. That's their mindset. They might talk to you like you folks, but they say, you know, I look at him as a good husband. You know what I mean? A lot of bitches think, if I can get the bottom bitch position, if I can finally get the bottom bitch position, you know what I mean? I'm getting closer and closer to being a baby mama. If we're going to be real, and a lot of niggas might not say it, they might not say, yeah, you know what I mean? I insinuate or I hint that this is going to be my baby mama one day. But it's the smallest gestures that speak the loudest volume. And they know that if they put their foot down, they wouldn't be as deep as they are. They know if they sit up there and really put their foot down, bitch, ain't no favoritism in my ism. You know what I'm saying? If they really put their foot down and if they got rid of that bottom bitch position, if they did all that, they know it'll be holeless around this motherfucker. If we gonna keep it real. You know what I mean? If we're going to be honest, if we're going to be 100% honest, you know what I mean? And my question is this, to get to the end of life, to make it to the end of life, we're not going to get there with just one income, especially with kids. If we're going to be real, because if you have to go through a woman's sexual sensations, her emotionalism, her childhood traumas, you know what I mean? Her ego, her pride, you know what I mean? Her emotions, you know what I mean? Days where it's up and down. You got to go through all that for success, and you got one bitch, you're in trouble. That's not going to be enough money made to last you for the end of your life, especially if she wants children. And I'm just keeping it real. You know what I mean? A lot of people don't want to hear that. Who is Wiggs, top of it? Yeah, if she want to be the only bitch and you in this lifestyle, you're in trouble. Because there's no 401k in this shit. So whatever she makes, you know what I mean? If you don't generate that into some real revenue, you're in trouble. Especially if she ain't really running it up. Because it's not going to be enough money to last you to the end of your life. One income is not going to be enough to sustain no goddamn child neither. That's something to think about. Why a lot of bitches saying they want to be the only one. But, you know, nowhere in society has it been proven that a man and a woman should just be a one-on-one couple. That's something that was created in the 1800s. That monogamous relationship. You know what I mean? But a lot of women, they don't give a damn about teamwork and, you know what I mean? They're choosing off of their sensations. And their sensations, you know, and a lot of the times, it strokes their ego once you give in to those sensations. It's an ego and it's a power thing. This power dynamic, this power exchange, this wanting the power started, you know, during the feminist movement, the women's rights movement, you know what I mean? DC the Reason, top of it. Let's add people to the live. Everything I'm saying is for entertainment purposes. I don't promote or condone any criminal activities whatsoever. Let's add some more people to this live. Because there's a lot of women that need to hear this. But that power, the whole belief of, you know, I want power and I want this, that came from the women's rights movement, the women's suffrage movement. Because if you look at it, even in nature, why is it that a man can continue to reproduce and continue to have children no matter what age he is? He can be 45 and still shoot out sperm. Whereas a woman, she's only fertile for so long. You can't have children at a certain age. You know what I mean? Top of it. Let's add more people to the live. That's nature saying at the end of the day. You know what I mean? A man is designed to have multiple women. So if a man is designed to have multiple women, you know, jank, top of it. Jank stag, top of it. If a man is designed to have multiple women, and his lifestyle is imperative that he has multiple women. And if you don't have multiple women, you in trouble, because that money being made by that one bitch is not going to be enough to last you a lifetime. Especially when they all want children. So if you got a bitch that's running off every bitch, you know what I mean? She's going to have to work twice as hard. And the reality is, you know, she's going to run off every bitch and leave you for a square. Because she's not going to be able to handle all the pressure. She's not going to be able to handle all the pressure, all the ups and downs that's going to come with being the only bitch. Can you believe that? There's a lot of bitches that want to be the only one just to leave you for a square. That's something to think about. And that's some cold. That's a cold reality. And just know, if she's in it for a sensation and she wants to be the only bitch, you're building her up. You're building her up for somebody that's a lesser caliber of you. You're building her up for a square. If she wants to be the only bitch. If she wants to be the only bitch, she doesn't see the value within you. She doesn't say you're so valuable that other women need to experience you. So what you're going to do is end up building her up. You're going to build her all the way up, and you're going to get your little heart broke. Because a woman that values you, she'll bring another woman. A woman that doesn't value you, she doesn't want another woman to come, because if another woman comes, it's stopping her from her plan, her ultimate plan of being the only bitch and having power over you. It's stopping her from having power over you. You know what I mean? She can't have power over you if it's another bitch. She can't have her family that she always desired to have if it's another bitch. That's why that bitch keep running off every bitch. Because she doesn't value you, and she doesn't see the value in teamwork. Some bitches say they're independent because you're not a team player. That's the only reason why you think you're independent. If we're going to keep it real, and you don't see any other race of women saying pussy pink booty hole brown other than the black race, the black females. You know what I mean? The music industry shows you where the black, where black people are in general. You don't hear a lot of women rapping about their character. You don't hear black women rapping about femininity. You hear them talking about how big is this dick and how you can eat the booty hole like groceries. You know what I mean? And see, and look at how that's paying an effect on the lifestyle. That's problematic. Because now you have a guy that's trying to compete on the market, on a sexual market. You know what I mean? And that's why there's a lot of black single females, and the infrastructure in the family home is disconnected. That's why anytime you're dealing with a woman and you're dealing with a man, it's very important to establish these three things. Values. Anytime you're dealing with a woman, you know, establish her values. What do you value in life? What have you committed to? Have you ever been a part of a team? Have you ever been a part of any team? Did you have a man as a coach when you worked with a team of women? When you worked on a team of women, did you have a man as a coach? And how did that work? When you worked at that Target, how did you work with other people and employees? You were a team player when it came to Target, but you can't do it for a man that you care about. You know what I mean? That's very detrimental that you were a team player when it came to Target and Walmart, but you wasn't a team player when it came to your man. Pushing for success is because she don't value you. She'll value the rapper. She'll be the second, third girlfriend to the fucking rapper, but she don't think that you can do it. She don't believe that you're valuable enough to have another woman. Even in scripture, Sarah brought Hagar for Abraham in the Bible. If you look at the book of Genesis, look at the book of Genesis. Sarah brought Hagar. They consider Hagar a mistress, but you know, Sarah still brought Hagar. Now, you might not be a Christian. You might not believe in that doctrine. And I'm not a Christian myself, but I believe in the messages that the universe sends us. I believe that there's esoteric messages that we have to look at. The fact that we can continue to nut, you know what I mean, at any age, and a bitch is only fertile for so long. The fact that Sarah and Hagar, and you know, even in scripture with King Solomon, had multiple women. The fact that even in Luke, the book of Luke, with Jesus had multiple women help him. You know what I mean? Jesus had multiple women help him. I think it's Luke 8 verses 8:1-3. You know what I'm saying? I want y'all to look that up. You know what I mean? Jesus had multiple women help him. And a lot of people don't understand that this whole belief of a monogamous relationship started in the 1800s. You know, polygamy was always a prominent thing. Why do you think polygamy is illegal in the United States now? You know what I mean? You got to understand the truth and the reality of things. You got to ask, what do you value? What are your goals? And what are your views on the future? I want you guys, any relationship you're in or any young lady that you meet, you know what I mean? Or any man that you're with, it's essential that you ask those three questions. What do you value? And see what she values at the end of the day. And if she, and a lot of people, they gonna lie if we're gonna keep it real. You know what I mean? So what you do is, if they gonna lie about what they value, see how they were raised. How they were raised and tell you what they value. And then ask them their goals. What are your goals? And then ask them their views for the future, because yours and theirs might not align. You know what I mean? We're gonna add a book. Now, that's why I asked, did you choose with your pussy or your mind? You know, my question, top of it.
What's
how you
doing, Bill? All is well. Back home from work, cool.
That's right. You know, your day's been good. It's been prosperous for the most part.
Day's been prosperous, and I'm looking forward to an even more prosperous day tomorrow.
That's right. For everybody that's in the live, this is Bill. You know, this is also an individual that was a follower of Sinful. And he's somebody that's very, very knowledgeable. And he's somebody that loves information and game and wisdom and knowledge. You know what I mean? Yes, indeed. What you think about the topic, Bill?
It's good, because it just reminds me of a message that Sin had. It's just, you know, just using your mind. I'm summarizing it, of course, but he always encouraged everyone to use their mind and to know why you're doing something, to go for something based off substance over style. So, yeah. You're doing a good job, too, man. You're always having good topics. So, definitely blessings to you, brother.
I appreciate that, Bill, man. I really appreciate that, man. A lot of my lives, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take some of the lives and put them on YouTube. You know what I'm saying? So, I will have my YouTube page up soon. And, you're absolutely right. A lot of them are choosing for the wrong reasons. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. They choosing dick, you know what I mean, over character. You know what I mean? And there's not a lot of individuals that are holding the woman accountable in regards to this. We got to hold women accountable and let it be known that, hey, we don't choose dick over sensation, over success. You know what I mean? You don't choose dick over success, you know what I mean? Or over character. You know what I mean? And it always baffles me when I hear a young lady say, yeah, I'm going to school. I'm going to do 4 years in school. You know what I mean? I'm going to do 4 years. I'm studying to be in criminal law. I'm studying to be, you know what I'm saying, an attorney or a nurse or a doctor. But then you want to be a stay-at-home mom.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And why do you think women prioritize our females? Because I believe that a woman, you know what I mean, you have to have characteristics to be a woman. But many females, they're prioritizing the piece of paper over, you know, the character of the individual. You know what I mean? They prioritizing the degree. They prioritize their dog. They're prioritizing dick over the man and the characteristics of the man. Why do you think that is? Where do you think that stems from?
Well, one thing I will say, of course, I don't want to speak for all, but I do believe that her or other individuals, they always do things based off importance, right? Mm-hmm. Whatever they believe is important to them. And quite frankly, in her mind or any other one's mind, that's what that person sees as value. Mm-hmm. So with anything, I would say always try to just, man, no matter what they're doing, because I'm just at a point where I don't care what nobody else is doing. I don't care what she's doing. They'd be having these topics on like social media, stuff like that. And I remember it was something that Sin said, and I just kept it with me. I'm just going to be a man.
Mm-hmm.
And like, some will focus on this, some will focus on that, but I don't really care, right? And, you know, and those that see the value in what you're doing will gravitate to it. And those that do not, just like as I say now, Darwin will fix it. Man, mm-hmm. I don't worry about nothing. This is not to say I'm immune, I'm having it my way all the time. No. But no, that's just what I believe. Mm-hmm. But I think, and Andre Taylor spoke on this too, that just everything leads to value. And that might be in your relationship, that might be in your profession, and whatever you want, that if stuff is happening, this is just what that audience perceives to be as value. Mm-hmm. So, mm-hmm. Of course, you look at like principles of mind and character, of integrity, and that is what's important. But in all that you do, you have to present you or whatever you are after in a way that's valuable. And some will get it and some will not. Some will seek it and some won't.
Facts. You know what I mean? That's profound, because a lot of people do, you know what I mean? They sit around and they, you know, well, if this is what she wants, I'm going to conform to what she wants, instead of standing in the truth and saying, you know what? You know what I mean? I'm going to align myself with somebody that is more like-minded, and you know what I mean? They're going to take it or leave it. They don't. A lot of individuals don't have a take it or leave it approach. They have the approach of I'm going to conform into social norms or the status quo of things. And I think it's very profound when somebody's able to stand tall and say, you know, I don't give a damn what this person thinks. I'm going to be a man. You know what I mean? Because, you know, if I continue to be a man, you know, and when I continue to be a man, there's going to be a woman out there that sees the value in me, because, you know, my energy and me valuing myself is going to attract somebody that values me.
Right.
So I think that's very profound, man. And I'm glad that you came on Alive and you spoke on that.
Thank you, brother. I appreciate you inviting me, man. And you've been doing a heck of a great job. Looking forward to the documentary that you're putting out. And just, man, I just see the game using you, and, you know, you're doing great things in the future.
I greatly appreciate that, brother. Documentary is still a work in progress, man, and we definitely got to stay in touch.
Definitely. And those that just tuned in, we're talking about acting. We're talking about theatrical stuff, man. We're not talking about nothing illegal. We're talking about all hypothetical situations. Matter of fact, the good brother here, he's a traveling magician. So
no doubt.
Nothing here was said that was illegal. You know, I'm an impeccable square. I'm an impeccable square and massage therapist and trainer in Washington, D.C. So if you're looking at this and say, wow, these brothers are talking some fantastic stuff, but I need to get in shape, then you know, definitely I'll let me. But yeah, we are talking about hypotheticals. We're not talking about criminality. We're not talking about none of that stuff. So, you know, we're all just talking about fiction in our minds.
No doubt. Y'all need to put down the corn chips, put down the Philly cheesesteaks, and y'all need to get with Bill if you want to be in shape. You know what I mean? I know a lot of y'all think that having a baller belly is something that's sexy, but I'm here to tell you it's the summertime, man. You need to get your yolks on. I appreciate you, Bill.
Thank you, brother. Anytime. Thanks for having me. All right.
You know what I'm saying, man? We just had Bill, you know what I mean, join us. You know what I mean? For everybody that's interested in being in shape and healthy, I want you guys to add Bill, you know what I mean? And don't be afraid to reach out to Bill, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, man, you know, it's just a blessing to know that there's individuals that know their value. Because in all saying this, did you choose pussy? You know, did you choose, Did you choose with your pussy or your mind? That's also a woman that doesn't value herself in itself. And if you allowed yourself to be in a continuous battleship or up and down with this individual, you know, you didn't value yourself. If you were somebody that only values dick, that shows you a lot about yourself. You didn't value yourself. Because my thing is this, if somebody only wants one thing from you, they can never enjoy everything that comes with you. You know, Arthur, blessings. High-minded, hungry, blessings. I'm going to say it again. If you only, if at the end of the day, somebody only values one thing from you, they'll never enjoy everything that comes with you. And let me say this too. A lot of people say, man, where did this mindset or this, you know, thinking or, you know what I mean, this type of rhetoric of, I don't need a nigga. Where did that stem from? The feminist movement, the women's rights movement, you know what I mean? Even the civil rights movement. You know, all these things stem from a system. It's a systematic approach to deprogram and disconnect the black man and black woman. And that's shown even in the lifestyle. It's shown in everything that we do that they say they don't need a nigga. You know what I mean? But my thing is this. Black men don't have a history of having power over a black woman. You know what I mean? You also got to look at the Industrial Revolution because you had producers versus consumers. You know what I mean? When they start letting women work in factories and start working jobs, look at how the relationship became a disconnect. You know what I'm saying? Then you got to look at Title IX. I want everybody to do their research on Title IX when you get the chance. You know what I'm saying? But when we start becoming consumers instead of producers, that hurt the family because the black man and black woman stop working together when we start becoming consumers. You know what I mean? When we was producers, we was working together on them farms. We would grow our own crops. The black man and black woman work together. So now look at how that plays out in today's society. You know, black people, I don't need a nigga, pussy bing, booty hole brown. You know what I'm saying? You see how it works now? Peabody works, top of it. To be honest, they can't even blame it on us, P. Black men haven't been in the homes in the last 30 years. It's been a little bit longer than that. You know what I mean? 81% of black homes were filled with black men and black women in the 1988. That's the last time it was 81%. Now it's less than 46%. You know what I mean? That's a dramatic change. You know what I'm saying? So now there's a gender war. So now with the gender war, what that look like in the lifestyle? And the lifestyle, what it looks like is you see a lot of niggas trying to prove themselves to the bitch. You see a lot of niggas trying to convince the bitch instead of the man being chose. Prove to me that I am a necessity. Prove to me that you're a necessity towards me. You know what I mean? That's what the Industrial Revolution did when women started to be able to work just like men. You know what I mean? When I think that black men and black women no longer grew their own crops, they didn't have to work together anymore. And the lifestyle is the closest thing to where a black man and black woman can work together. Because they traded their physical man for the government. Yeah, they chasing the bitch instead of the other way around. You don't really see any other race saying, I don't need a man other than the black race. You know what I mean? And I'm going to tell y'all this. If you hear a broad say, all he did was fuck on me, at the end of the day, that's all he was doing was just fuck on me, you know, stay away from her. Cause my thing is you allowed it and that's what you wanted. Hold that bitch accountable. It ain't all he did was fuck on you. That's all you wanted. You know what I mean? That's all you wanted. You know what I mean? It wasn't that all he was doing was fucking on me. You know, I asked the question, at what age will you choose success over your sensations? I've been asking that for a very long time. You know what I mean? Cause a lot of the bras, they don't have forever. You know what I mean? It's easy to say you're independent and you're not a team player. You know what I mean? It's easy to say you're independent and all you want is some dick. It's easy to say that. First place rule at top of it. You know what I mean? And for everybody, I want you guys to rewatch this live and really listen and pay attention to some of the things I've been saying, because I've been dropping jewels. I'm pro-black for sure, but it's deeper than color. It's saying all skin folks ain't kin folks. Facts. Across the seas in the third world countries, women were raised to cater towards their husbands and let the man lead. Facts. And when I say the black female, I'm going to say this. Being black can be a mentality. If all you care about is dick, you know what I mean? If all sucker repellent top of it, backdoor 200 top of it. My thing is this, if all you care about is dick, why does it matter if you want a child or not? Just fuck for the rest of your life. Why sit up there and worry about, you know what I'm saying, something serious at the end of the day, like a family, when that's all you want is some dick? And for all the dick you've gotten, what do you have to show for? That's what I like to ask the young ladies. For all the dick you've gotten, you know what I mean, what the hell do you have to show for? You know what I mean? You've taught every single guy how to treat you, and you still left. You taught every single guy that, you know what I mean, I'll go hard for you if you give me some dick, and you still left him. You were in control of your life for 18 years, and you still failed. You've owned your pussy, you know what I mean, your whole life, and you've done nothing with it. You know what I'm saying? You say you know your worth, but you give yourself up for free. Even geisha females, geisha women, you know, they sell their virginity. My thing is, you can't say you know your worth when you give things up for free. You know what I'm saying? And the reality is this. How do you determine your value? Oh, I don't put a price on my pussy. How do you determine your value? You know what I mean? How do you determine your value? Because you're running out of time. At 25, majority of guys look at you as used up, because you came from somebody else. You know what I mean? Because, you know, it's the same story. He gives you all the dick in the world, and any man that gives you all the dick in the world and whenever you want it usually are not successful men. You know what I mean? Because successful men, they're not governed by the spirit of lust. They're not governed by just dick. Excuse me, by just pussy. You know, you guys, you know, you got some fellas out there that, anyways. But yeah, majority, they're not, they the same drive they have for sex is the same drive they have for success. If the young ladies took that same drive they have for sex and placed success and reversed it towards success, man, that's why I asked, what did you choose with? So when a bitch say that, you know, I loved him, I was down with him for 3 years, you know, I was down with him for 3 or 4 years, you know, and then he went to jail. I'm so tired of hearing stories about bitches falling in love with niggas that's in jail. You know what I mean? That's why I asked him, what did you choose? Did you make a decision to be with this man based off of what he told you, or based off of what was valid and what he can show you? Did you choose based off the physical appearance, or did you choose off of his characteristics? Because I hear the stories all the time. He's in jail, I'm going to stay down for him. You know what I mean? Because they associate any man with sexually pleasing them with a nigga that just fresh out of jail. You know what I'm saying? And that's why they go for the jail nigga, because they associate that with good dick. Any person that doesn't have a brain, their brain is in their dick. And I'm going to be real, the only way to a lot of these bitches' minds is through they pussy. That's not the type of bitch that's going to get you rich or wealthy. You're going to be going in circles. You know what I mean? They want a situation they can control and be comfortable in. And the sooner people understand that, the better off you'll be. To conclude everything that I'm saying in general, you know what I mean? It's very essential that you find people that are evenly yoked. You don't have to believe in scripture to believe in this, but you guys have to value the same things. You guys have to have similar goals and views on the future. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? They associate, they have the wrong association. And I'm going to say association brings similarity. So if she associates with a nigga that was in jail, that tells you what she wants. A lot of times bitches say they want a real man, they want a good man, but they don't know how to identify that. They don't know how to identify what a real man is and what a good man is. And to be real with you, a lot of them just want some good dick. You know what I mean? That's the reality of things. That's the world we live in. And a lot of people would deny it, but it's the truth. So you might say, well, Ron, what do? Exactly what Bill said earlier. Align yourself up with people that are like-minded. Exactly what I just said. Be evenly yoked. You know what I mean? And when you meet these people, let me say this too. Ask them. You know, if you've been in a relationship for a while, ask them. The things you know about me now, would you still want a relationship if you knew everything about me that you know now in the beginning? You know what I mean? That's why it's important to know somebody's highest needs. And like I said, you guys should write down you guys' highest needs on a piece of paper separately. You know, don't show it to each other right away, but then show it. And you have to see where, you know, fucking ranks. You know what I mean? Because for some women, that's a deal breaker if you're not blowing her back out every 5 minutes. But the reality is this, that's not the reality for every man. And that's not the reality for every woman, because the reality is you're going to have days where you do good. You're going to have days where you're doing bad. Shit. That's just real. And then, you know, and then life happens. You're not going to have the same energy for somebody 24/7. You might be, you know, you might be thinking about a different bitch. Shit. If we can keep that shit real. Henry, top of it. Shout out to Henry. I would say he's the best barber in the whole Bay Area. I want y'all to add Rodas, RODAS _ Henry. Best barber in the Bay, hands down. You know what I mean? But that's very essential, man. It's very essential that, you know what I'm saying, you understand who you're dealing with and where they came from and who they came from. You should ask about their previous relationship, because there's a lot of unspoken expectations. It's a lot of unspoken expectations. You know what I mean? And a lot of times it's rare that a female sit up there and say, I just want some dick. Her actions will show you everything you need to know. You know what I'm saying? With that being said, you know, we're now entering, I believe this is more than 59 minutes. I believe I've went longer than 59 minutes at this point. But I've touched every point that I've wanted to touch with on this topic. You know, I appreciate the people that are still on this live. And I will have my YouTube channel, excuse me, up soon. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, you know, definitely inbox me, you know, and I'll get back to you promptly. Or if you want to have a private conversation, you know, in regards to a serious matter, or if it has anything to do with gang, you can click on the link in my bio and it'll take you straight to my page. And when you click on my page, my website, you can scroll down to the consultation and you can schedule a consultation. You know what I mean? If people that I fuck with already, you know what I'm saying, you got my number, you can call me. Or if you don't have my number, you know what I mean, DM me and we can talk on a private note. But I appreciate everybody that joined the live. Peace and blessings. Look forward to my more lives on YouTube coming soon. You know what I mean? One.
Get people on this live real quick.
you know. Mickey Mouse boy, top of it. You know what I mean? We have a great topic tonight, a great topic. Let's get more people in the live. We have an amazing topic tonight. Bands the Gent, 365, top of it. Did you choose with your or your mind? You know what I'm saying? We're going to put the title. You know what I mean? Did you choose with your pussy or your mind? And then why many don't believe they could be rich with black women. You know what I mean? We're going to talk about it tonight. We're going to talk about it tonight. Let's add people to the live. Did you choose with your pussy or your mind? While many don't believe they can be rich with black women within the lifestyle or outside of the lifestyle, you know what I'm saying? We're going to talk about it tonight, though, man. You know what I'm saying? A great topic tonight. Blessings to everybody that's in the live. Let's get the ladies in the live. Let's get everybody in the live. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? Peace and blessings to everybody. You know? Let's get more people in the live. I hope everybody had a prosperous day. And this, you know, this topic, a lot of people might disagree with some of the things that I have to say. You know what I mean? But tonight, you know, I'm giving nothing but the truth. I can't beat around a bush. I gotta call it the way I see it. You know? Top of it. You know what I mean? That music in the background, man, that's the stylistics. That Hurry Up This Way Again, man. There's even a message within the song. Hurry Up This Way Again. You know what I'm saying? Top of it. Off top, man. Appreciate it. We're gonna dive right in. Did you choose with your pussy or your mind? You know what I mean? This topic, man, is very, very, very essential, man, because a lot of people, man, they not choosing with the right things. They choosing based off of what they pussy feel, based off of what they thought, or based off of what they know. You know what I mean? Thinking becomes an afterthought. That's all I always ask the question. If you met the man in which, you know, your ideal man, you know, in regards to looks, if he looked like what you would physically want, you know what I mean? He's handsome, he's cute, you know what I mean? And he had a big old dick, you know what I'm saying, at the end of the day, would that be enough? Do you think that the end result would still be success? You know what I mean? Would that still equal success if you had the ideal male that you wanted? You know what I mean? Because that's a real question. Would it still amount to success? Or is success an afterthought? That's why I always post that on my Instagram. Ambassador Ron posts that a lot. Cynic, top of it. You know what I mean? But without further ado, let me get right into the topic. Hey, Bands, I want to add you in the topic once we get more people in here, man. But I want to start with the topic and get it flowing. And I definitely, we need the ladies in this live, man. There's no reason why we don't have a certain amount of women in this live. You know what I'm saying? But my question, man, you know, I have to ask this question. To a lot of the ladies, man. You know, Bill, top of it. Blessings to Bill. This is a very important topic. And let me say this too. Punchy, top of it. Let me say this too. This topic is so important. It goes deeper than just a lifestyle. Man, the topic goes way deeper than just a lifestyle, man. We about to really drop some real jewels in his life tonight. You know what I mean? And I want to have Bill and Bands join the live. But before we do that, I still want to get deeper into the message and really talk about it. You know what I mean? Man, the question I got, you know what I'm saying? And a lot of young ladies, you know, they may listen to this live a little bit later, and a lot of the fellas might listen to this live later. But the question I have is, you know, if sex is so important, you know, in a relationship, why be in a serious relationship? You know what I mean? Why endeavor to even be in this lifestyle if fucking is, you know what I mean, that important to you? You know what I mean? Just have fuck buddies for the rest of your life. You know what I mean? Arthur, top of it. Let's add more people to the live. You know what I mean? Just have fuck buddies for the rest of your life. You know what I mean? There's no purpose in, you know what I mean, even having anything serious. You shouldn't trip off of what woman he, you know, talks to, because at the end of the day, it's just about dick for you. You know what I'm saying? If it's all about, you know what I mean, your sexual desires, why do children even matter? Why even have children? If sex is the highest priority. You know what I mean? Because we got to talk about this in a lifestyle and even outside of the lifestyle, because it's too many people, you know, in all reality, they're choosing just off of that. Believe it or not, there's a number of individuals that are only in this lifestyle, some of the fellas that are only in this lifestyle because they want some pussy. You know what I mean? If we're going to keep it real, they're not in this lifestyle to get no generational wealth or nothing like that. They only in the lifestyle because they want some goddamn pussy. And this is a slick way for them to get some pussy. If we're going to keep it real, you know what I'm saying? So, I'm not a fan of just doing things just to do it. You know what I mean? I believe in, you know, if I'm a fuck, we're going to fuck with a purpose. You know what I mean? I'm not into just doing things just to do it, because that would make you a trick. If you're just doing things just because, you know, just to do it, what separates you from a trick? You know what I mean? So, you got to ask yourself that. And another thing is this. Black females prioritize sex more than any other race of women. You know, I had to make that statement, man. A lot of people might not agree. They be like, "Oh, Ron, you, come on, man, Ron, come on, Ron." You know what I mean? Every bitch likes fucking. That's not what I said, though. That's not what I said. Black females prioritize sex more than any other race of women or any other race of females. You know what I mean? They prioritize the wrong things. I'm just going to keep it real. Now, I'm not speaking for one person in particular. I'm speaking as a mass. You know, I can back up everything that I'm saying. You know what I mean? Majority of impoverished households are held by single black women with children. And if you don't believe me, I want you to look it up. Go to blackstatistics.com and go to households, black households, and scroll all the way down, and exactly what I'm saying will show. Okay? So I just gave a little bit of homework for y'all. So, you know what I mean? Because if it was all about a man's character, there wouldn't be single black women, you know what I'm saying, with children in poverty. You have more black women in Section 8 than ever before. You know what I mean? In public housing, in ghettos. But hey, you know, I got my own spot. You know what I mean? I got my own spot. You know what I mean? I don't need a nigga. I got my own spot. Fuck these niggas. You know what I mean? Pussy pink booty hole brown. You know what I mean? That's their mentality. You know what I'm saying? So, you don't see any other race of bras doing this. You don't see Arab, anti, top of it. You don't see Arabian women prioritizing sex. You don't see them running around here talking about pussy pink booty hole brown. Take me to pound town. I'm thugging with my rounds. You don't see Arabian women doing that. You don't see Asian women doing that. You don't see Filipino women doing that. You don't see Caucasians doing that. You know what I'm saying? Beautiful Marv, how you doing? Blessings. But you don't see Arab and Asian and Filipino and Caucasian women prioritizing sex over success. And I just have to tell the truth. Now, I'm not speaking about anybody, you know, as an individual. I'm talking about the masses. You know what I mean? I'm speaking about the masses. And the reality is their views of success are surrounded by sexual sensations. Their views of success are surrounded by sexual sensations. Let's add more people to the live. We have to add more women to the life. And see, a lot of people are not going to say what I'm saying because they're scared to hold themselves and that bitch accountable. I'm just going to call it the way I see it. They're scared to do that. They're scared to hold her accountable. They're scared to hold themselves accountable. That's why I say, you know, at the end of the day, two people should write down their top five highest needs. You know, rather you in a square relationship, Mac Maroy, top of it. Two people should write down. Two people should write down, you know what I'm saying, their highest needs in a relationship and see where sex ranks. And this is real because there's no way you're going to be successful if they prioritize your sexual desires over success. I am yo, top of it. And I'm just keeping it real. And black females prioritize sex more than any other race. $2 Steve, top of it. That's why you see a lot of brothers saying they want white bitches. And I'm just going to keep it real. You know what I mean? That's why you see a number of black brothers saying, I'd rather have me a white bitch. Because at the end of the day, you know what I'm saying? If you sit up there and you have a black female, she's going to prioritize sex more than any other ra-